Never checked my helmet.
I think
out.
It was because
it
I could said
have been, it could
a,
have been
you,
here.
I said no. I said look at that big old ding in your visor.
Yeah, it was fine.
Did it knock you out?
No.
Nah. No.
No,
not this
it.
Time. Nah. He's fine.
No,
walk
I,
it off.
I just had to pull my bike out of that hole.
Yeah.
But
I think that's what took you the longest.
I did
the
go over my handlebars up here above your house and hit a tree. Remember I hit my front brake on that stick?
Every podcast, I learned something new.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Every podcast. This is Jess's first real podcast, and I am watching her face, and she's like, what the hell? Zach, you have children. Is that like crossing your mind, Jess?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to make that clear. Okay.
Well, I wasn't going that fast.
The last time you broke your femur, you also weren't going that fast. So.
No,
you broke
I wasn't.
Your femur?
Yeah, once.
When?
On the track.
Oh, it was a long.
Here?
No, it wasn't on the track.
Oh, I thought it was
no,
on the track.
That was at Winchester Bay.
Mm. Oh, at the coast?
Yeah.
The dunes are dangerous.
That's the only time I think I've ever done a Superman.
Ask him about his brand new pants on the Oregon dunes.
Don't ever wear brand new gear to the sand dunes.
Why?
Because what happens?
You'll ruin them.
How?
You'll put a big tear in them.
You know, that was
when you fall down.
That was the weirdest trip. That was the strangest motorcycle trip I've ever been on. Because I've been to the sand dunes.
Okay.
Hundreds of times, probably.
I don't like the dunes. I'll be honest with you. I'll throw it out
I've
there.
Been
I'm not a big dunes rider.
That's the first place I really started riding was the sand dunes.
Right.
And we all used to go in winter, in the summer, spring, whatever. That was the first time I'd ever been to the sand dunes when it was snowing.
Oh, that's right.
That was strange.
That was weird because we did have snow on the dunes.
And some of the small dunes were like frozen.
Mm-hmm.
So you'd hit some of them and they're soft and some of them were like ice cubes. The one I hit was like an ice cube.
And then you high-sided.
And I was trying to be cool and pass Seth.
You're never too old to be cool.
And
you know
I did
that, right?
pass. I did pass him, but I wasn't exactly.
You weren't on your bike, though.
On my bike, though.
When you passed him. As Jess is just shaking her head.
Off. That's what you call whiskey throttle.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, been there, done that a few times.
So, this is going
to
be a supporter.
I know, right?
Well, I know these shenanigans go on.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We always say if you're not going over the handlebars, you're not riding.
No. That's why I don't go.
So
sometimes you go over the handlebars when you're not really even moving.
What?
When was that?
Like when? Well, even in Idaho, we'd go like cross a log or something.
Oh,
and
crap!
Wipe
yeah.
out.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Or just fall off the side
I
of the trail.
I had a big old rut and fell down.
Yeah.
And wasn't going very fast.
Like first gear?
Yeah, for sure.
You look like a real professional when you do that.
Well, I've had a lot of practice at falling down.
Anyway.
I've learned to bounce. But, yeah, no. What?
What? Have you learned to bounce?
I think so. I've fallen down enough. Like this last trip, I wasn't going to show you my arm, but then you piped up on the Facebook Live and said, do you need stitches?
Well,
and I said, no.
He's
yeah. like, oh.
Maybe.
It's like, no, I don't need stitches. My elbow hurts.
Elmer's glue.
Yeah. I had a big old bruise on my hip.
I feel like you need to add the super glue to your first aid kit in the trailer.
Yeah, probably a few other items, too.
Bubble gum.
Super glue.
Yes.
Super glue.
What else?
Duct
tape.
No, that's too big and bulky.
Would you call it grandpa's, not liquor, but you should have some of that in there for as a painkiller.
Oh, that's right.
What did you call it?
elixir?
Elixir.
Maybe?
Yeah,
grandpa's
elixir. Yeah.
Grandpa's elixir. That's what we need in there.
Like wine and
it's a bottle of whiskey.
That's
all we need for when we get back to the trailer.
Yeah, old granddad.
Yeah, old granddad. I think I have a picture of you in Idaho. Was it? What was that we were drinking there?
Old Overholt.
Yeah, there we go.
What?
Old Overholt. Rye whiskey.
It's pretty good.
Delicious.
Yeah. Sitting down by the Boise River. After a hard day of riding.
Yeah.
Which was good. But yeah. So you get a new helmet, right? That's on your agenda.
Yeah, I second that.
Yeah.
His birthday's coming up. So.
There we go. Oh, yeah, your birthday is coming. So we got the birthday, the annual.
Next month.
Yeah, the annual birthday ride's coming up.
Yep.
So we got to get that going.
Are we going to plan ahead or just the day of?
The day of.
Okay. The day of, yeah.
That one, at least I know. I know that one's coming.
Yeah. So we got that one coming up. We can do that one. We got anything else planned up? No?
Not really.
We got to.
You signed up for a poker run or something.
We did?
I kind of signed us up for a couple poker runs. I forgot to tell you.
Just saying.
Oops.
Did you actually play poker?
I don't know, but one's got. One's in Washington. In fact, they actually Facebooked or contacted me back to see if we were coming, if they could count on us coming.
Right.
Well, we are pretty popular.
We are.
You have a YouTube.
We have a YouTube channel now.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So we are something.
So we
now.
Are legit. So to that kid, to our biggest fan, tell your dad. Take a hike. We are somebody now.
Oh, yeah.
Geez. Yeah. So that's all I can say to the biggest fan.
Here we go.
So, yeah. I don't have much more. Do you have anything? Nothing?
Nothing. I think Jess learned a lot.
I think Jess is in, yeah, saying, overload, saying, I don't know about you guys. And
yeah.
And has she ever heard about all the... like 5 miles of hell stories?
Most of it, I think.
Probably all the good stuff.
Like,
but I would be curious what their take is on what we're thinking. It would be kind of funny.
Yeah.
I feel like every vacation, mancation that Zach goes on, it's always to someplace really remote, and he doesn't have service. And whether or not that's true.
Was that air quotes?
That was air quotes. I saw. Which I'm fine with. But they always find themselves in the most remote places. Thankfully for us, April's got the spot. Is it the spot?
It's the spot. So I try to keep everybody updated.
Yeah,
like
she
on
keeps all the wives
Facebook and stuff. But
in the know,
there's so many times that he's like, "quote, we're out of service," and I'm like, mm-hmm. "Oh, okay, wink, wink, nod, nod."
No, we are out of service.
Here we go. Here's the thing: as long as you let one of the wives know. We'll let each other know, you know, that you're safe. But if you're completely out of service for 12 days or 14 days, I think we all get a little antsy and we start like messaging each other like, have you heard anything? Have you talked to them? Have you seen anything? So your Facebook Lives at the top of the world really does kind of settle all of our worries. So whether you're out of service, air quote, or out of service, air quote, letting us know you're alive helps. Right?
Yeah, I agree.
Like China Hat, we had service, but it didn't work.
Yeah, but that was really spotty.
And then Idaho, we really did have to ride a long ways out of camp.
Yeah, we had to get to the highest point we could.
We did it.
You did.
Yeah. And
we make a point.
I have some new stuff to share with you on the Idaho.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, there's what some new...
I don't know about?
Yes.
Oh, no.
There's some new trails that neither one of us know about that I just discovered.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. So back we go.
To Baumgartner?
Yeah, I think so. I think that...
At the same... Ooh.
On the other side, probably.
The other side? Same side.
It could be the same side. There's some stuff that we didn't know about on the side we were on.
Well, we didn't exactly know a lot.
No.
When we were there.
But there is one trail called like the Razorback or whatever. And from what I could see is it's on the back side of that lookout. And it comes down like a Razorback rock.
Oh, yeah. We didn't do that because that
I don't know where that was.
If we had one more day. That's what we would have done. But
yeah, we always on our vacations. Oh, sure. But we just need one more day.
We knew about we didn't want to ride Death Valley again. Mm-mm. And then we rode what's it called when we went down below that elk camp and rode the one that crosses the river that was washed out.
Oh,
Deadwood.
Deadwood. I think there's a reason why it's called Deadwood.
Remember that junction we took a picture of?
Yeah, yeah.
That's that trail I think you're talking about that goes clear around the lookout. But it was like another 20 miles. Yeah,
it comes. I think it comes from the top of the lookout, and you ride down the backside of that.
Yeah.
So, I've found a contact that sells a map that he's got out there. So, which is crazy.
Sorry.
Hey, easy. What are you doing? Oh. So yeah. So we got. There's. Jess, I'll be honest with you. There's lots of antics when we go riding together. And
big surprise.
Big surprise there. We're never prepared. Yes.
Next time you go, you're pulling down the full bed for Zach so he doesn't have to sleep with the mattress.
Yeah.
I heard about that.
Well, mm-hmm. we couldn't get it all the way down because we had a lot of crap under there.
We were lazy.
We didn't want to. Yeah. And then he goes, God. This thing's really lumpy. It's like, well, yeah, because this is propped up underneath it, poking you up. Of course it's going to be lumpy. So, yeah, I'll take the big bed down next time.
This is why the girls don't go with you. Because if we did, we would demand things like this. And we wouldn't dry our boots by a fake fire.
That fake fire works.
Who dries their boots by a fake fire? Okay, that's us.
It eventually works. The fire doesn't, but the vent that's right in front of it.
If nothing else, it works in spirit.
If they take us with them somewhere, it's going to be someplace tropical.
Right?
Costa Rica.
With the trailer?
I think we can get it down there.
Okay.
We did do research when we bought it, how long it had to be in order to cross the Mexican border, right? Canada.
That was God, you hit me right in the teeth. This is why you can't share one mic. You hit me right in the teeth. No, that was, we had to do all the research for Canada. You can only have a certain length.
40.
No, it's 40. A little more than that. Oh. No, don't try to make stuff up. But we could. Baja.
No.
Yeah, Baja. I got a map right behind me.
Jess and I want a hotel room with filtered water. Beautiful resort pools.
Mm. Mondello.
Access. And Mondello. All you can drink Mondello and the girls will go.
Okay. What if we do this for them? We tell them, we'll get you guys.
We're not here.
I like this look Jess has given me. So what we'll tell you. We'll start in Ensenada. Okay. Ensenada. Right up here. Up here on the Baja Peninsula. Okay. And so we're going to go about 1,300 to 1,500 miles, and we'll ride the beaches down to the very tip, which is Cabo San Lucas. So we'll meet the girls. What do you think? We could meet the girls in Cabo.
Mm. I like that plan.
And they could hang out in Cabo for a week while we...
Dos cerveza, please.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah,
and so, and then Zach and I, we head down the coast, free ride it. We'll probably have to have a guide service, honestly.
And an EMT.
I feel like he's not sold. Yeah,
I don't think he's on board.
I'm trying to think at the logistics here.
No. He's thinking.
We rent bikes or
wait,
do we take our own?
The girls are at the pool having cervezas.
Yeah, I know. That's another thought.
No. We'll be having cervezas
every night
okay. While we're down. When we stop and
but do we have to? We rent bikes or do we take our own bikes?
Which would you like to do? Because we can do either.
Well,
are
we going to ride both directions?
If we go, no.
So then we'd have to get them back somehow.
So here, if we did a guide service, I think I can get us from Ensenada down to Baja, their bikes.
Yeah.
Their deal.
Then we don't have to take them back.
No.
On an airplane or something.
Or we could do, there's also Ensenada, we could ride down and come back. So we could leave the girls at Ensenada, too, which is a beach. You have a beach there at Ensenada.
April's nodding, so it's good.
So yeah, Ensenada's fine. Now, if we go down around November.
Oh, yeah, the middle of November.
There's a little ride going on called the Baja 1000.
Yeah, and we could just sign up for that.
No.
Pits are expensive.